War Thunder has a problem. You know it. I know it. Your crazy Uncle Dave knows it. Every single War Thunder player knows it. Ghost Shells have been in the game since day one, with thousands of players complaining about them. Let's get into exactly what they are. A Ghost Shell is very simple. It's when you shoot, and while you may see the shell hit the enemy, it does nothing. No damage at all. But how do Ghost Shells actually work? The War Thunder servers are connected to your computer by a mysterious entity known only as the Internet. This is where we will find where ghost shells come from. A ghost shell is generally one of two things, coming either from netcode or desync. Now, while the outcome of these two things are essentially the same, the inner workings are very different. Let's start off with netcode, but first we have to go deep into how latency works with games. Whenever you do anything in War Thunder, a signal goes from your computer to the server. This is essentially the computer telling the server what to do. This action takes time though, known as latency or ping, measured in milliseconds. The game measures ping and how long it takes your transmission to go from your computer to the server, then back to your computer. However, as we have not found a way around the laws of physics yet, this action cannot be instant. There are ways to make it faster, or even pretend it's faster than it actually is. To make it faster, there's two options. Either faster transmission speed, or shorter distance for transmissions to travel. For faster transmission speed, there's a bunch of tiny things that we honestly don't have time to get into, but for distance traveled, it's as simple as getting the server as close to the computer as possible. However, this would mean Gaijin actually getting new servers, and we all know that isn't going to happen. But if you remember from before, we can employ little tricks that make it seem to have less latency. This is where netcode comes in. Netcode has no specific definition, but it's a blanket term for ways to synchronize game clients. Now, there's lots of ways to do it, but the one that War Thunder uses is known as authoritative netcode. Authoritative netcode is kind of complex, but to simplify it, the client sends transmissions to the server, and then does whatever the transmission says. This is very good against cheaters. Cheaters could easily exploit the game without it. All they could do is modify some game files, have an instant reload, and shoot as much as they want. So the server automatically checks every input, and makes sure it's possible. Now this seems good and all, apart from the fact that all actions would then have a lot of delay, based on how much latency there is. The trick the game employs here is to make it seem faster than it is, literally predicting the future. When you shoot, instead of waiting for the server to confirm, it shoots immediately for you. This is called client-side prediction. So, the server automatically checks every input, and makes sure it's possible. But if it's not possible, it transmits back that the input shouldn't happen. But since the computer has predicted that it happened, the shell you shoot still gets shown. The same exact thing happens when you are in a fight. You might shoot at an enemy, and your shell might still display, but in reality you are already dead before you shot. So, if we know why this happens, why don't we fix it? Why don't we just say that both of them count? Well, this would be unfair on the player that actually shot first, so the game developers are stuck in an unwinnable position. Both situations are bad, and extensive research is done often to find a way around this. But that's not the only type of ghost shell. There's also desync ghost shells.